All right, when exactly was the very beginning for the two of you, anyway?
Well, don't you remember? You introduced us.
Daphne, this is my brother Niles.
You're Daphne?
Why, yes, I am.
Well, when Frasier told me he'd hired an English woman, I pictured someone a little more... not quite so. You're Daphne?
Right again.
Look at you, Niles. Nice to meet you. The woman's a stranger to you, and yet you're ready to hand her your heart.
I may have been a tad smitten. What's your point?
My point is... Niles, pay attention. My point is your so-called realistic picture of Daphne has been clouded from the start by your intense attraction to her.
All right. Perhaps at the beginning I was blinded by infatuation, but over the years, I've learned everything about her, and my love has only deepened. I've learned that she's caring and compassionate, and she can be moody sometimes. She likes jelly on her pancakes instead of syrup. Her laugh, it's like music. Oh, and that girl can dance.
You're beautiful. You're a goddess.
Oh, I don't ever want this moment to end.
Then let's not let it.
This is one of my favorite memories. See, that's the dress I wanted her to wear this weekend. Isn't she spectacular?
Indeed she is.
She's perfect. Oh, wait, look at this. Watch. I come here often.
I suspect a part of you has never left.
Can you blame me? Look at us. We're magnificent together. We're moving in perfect sync.
There's that word perfect again.
I know what you're thinking. Just because this evening was perfect doesn't mean I'm idealizing Daphne.
Niles, did you hear yourself out there? You called her a goddess. You can't build a higher pedestal than that. Who could possibly compete with that sort of image?
That's not fair. I'm well aware that's just one side of her. I'm also acquainted with her ordinary, domestic, everyday side.
Doom-da, 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 doom-da,
heart and soul. Doom-da, I fell in love with you, heart and soul. Doom-da, the way a fool would do.
Oh, please. What? Even your everyday memories are idealized. How long until the cartoon bluebird lands on her shoulder?
All right. So maybe my memories of Daphne are perfect. Did it ever occur to you that perhaps Daphne just is perfect?
Because you held me tight.
I held you tight and served you right. I stole your kiss.
Good night. I'm going home.
Wait. How come?
Nothing else to say. Niles, I love you. And I love Daphne. I just hope the two of you can work this thing out together.
No, wait. Don't go. Help me understand. Why is everyone acting like I've done something wrong? The only thing I am guilty of is loving Daphne, and that's all I've ever done.
Yes. Yes, and how did you love her? From afar. You were never in love with her. You were in love at her. Now you've been given a chance to experience her in a real relationship, and yet for some reason you're resisting it. Rather than see her as she really is, you keep holding on to the fantasy.
No, that's not true.
Niles, the woman gained 60 pounds. And everybody in the world saw it but you. All you ever saw was a perfect woman in a red dress.
Okay. If you're right, and that's a big if, why would I do that?
Maybe Daphne's not the only one who's afraid she won't measure up. Maybe you're afraid too. After all, if it turns out that she's not perfect, then there's a chance things won't work out. Then not only will you lose Daphne, but you'll have wasted the last 7 years of your life chasing an illusion.